Hello students, welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. Children, we were discussing chapter 4, change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Today we will discuss about the preparation of the balance sheet of the reconstituted firm. If you remember, in our previous class we have discussed about preparation of revaluation account. Today we will discuss the same by doing a problem. Ashok, Bheem and Chetan were partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2:1. The balance sheet as on 31st March 2015 was as follows. So there are three partners, Ashok, Bheem and Chetan, and their profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1. In front of you a balance sheet is given. Let us move to the additional information provided. Ashok, Bheem and Chetan decided to share future profits equally. So children, you can note down here that this is their old profit sharing ratio of partners, that is 3:2:1. And they have decided, the partners have decided to share the future profit equally. That is, there is a change in profit sharing ratio, because the old ratio is 3:2:1 and the new ratio they have decided to share it equally. So there is a change. So that change will make into effect from 1st April. Okay. So before the reconstitution, the change in the contract between the partner, some procedure have to be done. So before going for that, they have to prepare the revaluation account, partner's capital account and the balance sheet of the reconstituted firm. Reconstituted firm means the new firm. Okay, after that changes, what is the situation of balance sheet, that also you have to show. Before doing that, let us see the adjustment given. Goodwill of the firm. See this question. Goodwill of the firm be valued at rupees 3 lakh. So goodwill is given to you, 3 lakh goodwill is given. That on that certain calculation work is there. Okay. So on goodwill, you have to calculate the value of the firm's goodwill is given to you. So some working note is there. Next is land be revalued. So land, one asset is there, that is revalued. You are revaluing that value before reconstitution at rupees 1,60,000. So whenever these adjustments are there related to asset or liability, you have to tick mark on the item in the balance sheet. See, land, one adjustment is there on land, so you under tick mark on land. Okay, next one, and building. One more item of adjustment is there on building, be depreciated. Depreciated means decrease. So building also you have to tick mark, because there is an adjustment on that item. Okay. Next, third item, creditor of rupees 12,000 were not likely to be claimed and hence be written off. So there is a creditor to whom you are supposed to give 12,000, it is your liability, but they are telling that now you are not supposed to give that amount. Okay, so that means what? Your creditor decreases. Creditor decrease means what? Your liability decreases. Okay, this effect you have to show in the revaluation account. So whatever change is there in asset or liability of the firm, that will be shown in the revaluation of account before reconstitution of the firm. An effect of that revaluation account is the profit or loss that will be shared among the partners in their old profit sharing ratio, and that will be transferred to the next account, that is partners capital account. Before starting the actual working, that is preparation of revaluation of partners capital and balance sheet, what you have to do is, first of all, you have to underline the old ratio and the new ratio. Okay. After that process, you have to see, is there any item which we are supposed to distribute to the partner. So in this question, you can see general reserve is an item which you are supposed to distribute to the partner in their old profit sharing ratio. I have already discussed these things in our previous class. So general reserve, workmen compensation reserve, then profit and loss, accumulated profit and loss, then advertisement suspense account. If these items are there, then that have to be distributed among the partners. Okay. So now let us move to the working of this and see how the revaluation are prepared. There are two items which are shown for revaluation, and that is land and building. Okay. So children, now let us prepare a revaluation account. This is the revaluation account, and you know, this is debit side. Revaluation is same like profit and loss account. So what is on the debit side of profit and loss account? So if there is, see, so this is your revaluation account. On the debit side of revaluation account, you are supposed to post all the items, that is, we can write here, if your asset will represent asset as S and liability with L. Okay, so if your asset see children, moving back to the question, I can see here, land be revalued at rupees 1,60,000. In your old balance sheet, how much is the land? It's 1 lakh. Okay. When you purchase this land, it original cost was 1 lakh. And now when you revalued it, that is the market value of that land is 1,60,000. That means what? Land value have increased, isn't it? So increase in land means what? Which side you will show? Increase in asset. So you have to show asset increase is shown in the credit side. See, you can see here, I have represented asset increase with an arrow mark going upward. Okay, same you can show in your book also. Asset can be shown as an arrow mark pointed upward in the credit side. So whenever your asset increases, you are supposed to show it in the credit side. So here I can write by land. Okay, with how much value your land is increasing? See, it was original value is 1 lakh, but now the market value is 1,60,000. So how much increase is there? 60,000. So that you can write in that, how much increase that value you have to write. Okay, don't write 1,60,000. The difference of the two value you should write here. The next item, so land is over. Now what about building? Building be debt. Depreciated. What is the meaning of depreciated? You have to reduce the value of building. So you are asked to depreciate it by 6%. Okay, 6% means of 1 lakh you have to depreciate with 6%. So 1 lakh into 6%. So how much you will get? It will be 6,000. So children, that is asset value is decreasing. So whenever the asset values decrease, you have to show it in the debit side of revaluation account. What I am supposed to write here? Here I can write to building, because the building value is decreasing, and as you know, whenever the asset decrease, you are supposed to record it on the debit side of revaluation account. So to building account, and how much is decrease? 1 lakh into 6%, that will give you an amount of 6,000. Okay, so it the building is decreasing by 6,000. Okay, now one more item is given to you in the question, and that is creditors. Goodwill not be shown in the revaluation account. Only the assets and liabilities given in your old balance sheet, that will be affected with this revaluation. Okay, so the creditor is your liability, and you are asked that you are not supposed to pay this liability now. Okay, not likely to be claimed, hence that have to be written off. So your liability have decreased to 12,000. So where you will show it? revaluation account, this is the revaluation account, and your liability is decreasing. See, liability decrease, which side? It's on the credit side. What will you write over here? You will write by creditor. And how much is the liability which is being decreased here? It's 12,000 given in the question. 12,000. Okay. So the amount of 12,000 I have shown over here. Okay. Now what next? Next, what you have to do is you have to close this account. Just tell me which side is more. Of course, your credit side seems to be more, isn't it? How much is the amount? 60,000 plus 12,000. That will give you amount of 72,000. So I will write it on both the side. The amount which is more, I will show it in both the side as 72,000 I have written, and this side is short. How much short the amount is? It is short by 66,000. 72,000 minus 6,000, you will get 66,000. Now what I should write in front of this? This is the gain, or I can write profit. You can write gain or profit. So I am writing here profit. Profit here to gain transferred to partner's capital account, and the 66,000 you have to show, give to each of their partners, each of the partners in their old profit sharing ratio. And how much is their old profit sharing ratio? It is 3:2:1. So this 60,000 I will give to Ashok as 66,000 into 3 divided by 6. So I will get 33,000. Same I have to do with B. 66,000 into 2 divided by 6. So I will get 22,000. And for Chetan, it will be 66,000 into 1 divided by 6. So 11,000. So this is how revaluation account will be prepared. Now what about partner's capital account? After preparing the revaluation account, the next account which you have to prepare is partner's capital account. So after revaluation, the second item will be preparation of partner's capital account. Remember that order. Okay. Now partner's capital account, the first item will always be by balance brought down. Remember children, the first item which you have to show in partner's capital account is by balance brought down. Okay, this will be the first item which you have to show. This is your credit side, and this is your, sorry, that was your debit side, and this is your credit side. Now by balance brought down, now what, from where you will write the amount for this, to fill this by balance brought down? Look into your balance sheet. The balance sheet, the capital of the partners. For Ashok, it is 2 lakh. For Bheem, it is 1 lakh. And for Chetan, it is 50,000. That amount you are supposed to write. So, by balance brought down means what? It's the capital of the partners. And how much it is for Ashok? It is 2 lakh. Okay. So, I wrote 2 lakh here. And for Bheem, it is 1 lakh. And for Chetan, it is 50,000. So this amount I will write over here. After writing by balance brought down, the second thing that should come in order is you have to look into the liability side. You have underlined one item, that is general reserve. This general reserve of 60,000 you have to distribute among all the three partners in their old profit sharing ratio. What is their old profit sharing ratio? 3:2:1. So in that ratio you are supposed to distribute. Where you are supposed to show that? You have to show it in the credit side. So partners capital account credit side is the item because of which the balance of the partner will increase. So here you have to write general reserve. See, I am writing the short form general reserve, and this general reserve of amount of rupees 60,000 you will distribute to the partners in their old profit sharing ratio. So this side the amount will be there, this side the amount will be there, and this year also after calculation the amount which you will receive is 30,000, 20,000 and 10,000. When you distribute the 60,000 in their profit old profit sharing ratio, this is what you will receive. Okay, now moving back, the next item which you are supposed to post show here is the amount of revaluation profit. See, this is the amount of revaluation profit. So this amount of revaluation profit that you have to transfer, as you have written that you are transferring it to partner's capital account. So 33,000, 22,000 and 11,000 will be shown in partner's capital account in this side. Here you have to write by revaluation account, and for all the three partners you will show that amount. So your revaluation account will look like this. Okay, see, I have transferred the amount from your revaluation account, I have transferred the amount to partner's capital account. So three items are over. Now what about one more item is there, if you look into your book, that is the goodwill of the firm. So it is firm's goodwill. Firm means what? Who are the firm? These all partners, Ashok, Bhim and Chetan, together is the firm. So this is the firm's goodwill. 3 lakh is firm's goodwill. They are asking us to distribute this goodwill before reconstitution of the firm. So how you are supposed to distribute this goodwill? It's not in the profit sharing ratio, old profit sharing ratio, and it is not in the new profit sharing ratio, but the goodwill has to be distributed in the gaining and sacrificing ratio. Okay, so you have to calculate the sacrificing ratio of the partner. What is the formula? Old ratio minus new ratio. So for all the three partners you will calculate this old ratio and new ratio, and the amount which you will receive in this case. See, here I have shown a working note for the same calculation of sacrificing or gain profit sharing ratio. Here Ashok, Bhim and Chetan is been written. Their old share is 3/6, 2/6 and 1/6, and the new share of each of these partners is 1/3, 1/3 and 1/3, equal, no? So 1/3. Now I subtracted 3/6 with 1/3, so I got 1/6 sacrifice. Then when I subtracted 2/6 with 1/6, there was 0. Answer what I got was 0. And when I subtracted old ratio of Chetan with new ratio of Chetan, I got minus 1/6. So whenever you get the answer as minus, that is a gain. Okay, the next step what I did was, the value of the goodwill given to you in the question is 3,60,000. Sorry, 3 lakh. Now this 3 lakh I have distributed, or I have in their sacrificing and gaining ratio, I calculated and I got 50,000. That is 3,60,000 into 1/6. So I got 50,000. Now what is the journal entry in this case? The journal entry for passing of this entry is, gaining partner will be debited and sacrificing partner will be credited. So the journal entry is, Chetan account debited to Ashok account. So with that journal entry in mind, I have posted the entry Chetan account. See, on the debit side I have written, see, Chetan account debited to Ashok account. So in to Ashok account, capital account, but amount I have written in Chetan side, and by Chetan account, but amount I have written in Ashok side. So this is a contra entry. Okay, in your plus one class you have studied the contra entry, isn't it? So that with that contra entry I have shown the goodwill item. Now the most important part of this is closing the account, capital account. Now make total of both the side, you can find out that your when you close the account of Ashok, your credit side is more, this side is more. Okay, 3,13,000 you got on debits credit side, and but your debit side is short by 3,13,000. So here you have to close this account by writing to balance carry down. This is the capital of the new firm. To balance carry down, and Ashok, he is short by 3,13,000. Beam, he is short by 1,32,000. And Chetan, when you make total of his credit side and subtract with debit side with 50,000, you will get 21,000 in Chetan account debit side. So there, in front of that carry down amount, you will write all these balances. So this is partner's capital account. So revaluation account is over, partner's capital account is over. What about balance sheet? That is also requirement here. Now, for preparing balance sheet of the new firm, you have to look into the balance sheet of the old firm. In this, you can see land and building. You have tick mark on land and building. So there is some changes in the value of land and building, isn't it? Land have increased and building have decreased because of this revaluation. And this revaluation have been distributed. So some of the changes which have taken place over here is land amount will difference will be there. Building amount will be reduced because of depreciation. General reserve will not be shown in the books balance sheet of the new firm. And the capital of these partners, the capital account of this partner have changed. With that effect in mind, you have to show the balance sheet. Okay, so land, you have in your old balance sheet, the land is 1 lakh. Okay, because of that revaluation, now you can look into your revaluation account and you can find on the credit side 60,000 increase is there. So that 60,000 you have to show in your new part balance sheet. So your balance sheet land have increased with 1,60,000. Now what about building? Building in your old balance sheets, you can see, you can find out that building is of 1 lakh. Okay, building in your old balance sheet is 1 lakh, and because of the depreciation, that is decrease in the value of building with 6,000. So when you subtract, because revaluation account, there is decrease in the value, so you have to subtract that amount. So 1 lakh minus 6,000, you will get 94,000 as the building value. Rest of the item you can copy from your balance sheet, old balance balance sheet as it is. Whatever is given in your balance sheet, that same item you can write over here. Now regarding creditors, in creditor also, one adjustment was there, and the adjustment is the creditor of 1 lakh, out of that 1 lakh, 12,000 you are not supposed to give. So out of this 1 lakh creditor, you are not supposed to pay 12,000. So subtract from 1 lakh that 12,000 and you will get amount of 88,000. So children, your creditor have decreased by 12,000. So now the creditor liability is 88,000 only. The rest of the items, that is bills payable, you will write as it is. The capital of the partner, that when you check into the old balance sheet, you can see it is 2,01,50,000. But this is the old balance sheet, and from old balance sheet you will get the old capital. What is the condition of new balance sheet? Or new capital, this is the new capital what you have written in balance carry down, that amount you are supposed to write in the balance sheet of the new firm. So you can, after writing that amount, the balance sheet, the capital account of Ashok and Beam, there is a difference in that, isn't it? From your old balance sheet, the capital amount is different. So after writing this amount, make a total of this and you will get 4,72,000 in this side. And when you make total of both the side, you can find that your balance sheet is tallying with 6,04,000. So this is how you have to show this entry. revaluation, partners' capital, and balance sheet of the reconstituted firm. So, children, practice some more problems from your textbook. And now it is time to conclude today's class. Meet you in the next class. Don't forget to write the test paper. Meet you in the next class with a new topic. Till then, goodbye.